Puppy.
Excited.
Hi, Bubba. Did you get a puppy sister?
Oh my god.
Here, baby. Can I hold her?
Oh my god.
Who's this, Jason?
We need our new puppy, Sophie.
Hi, Sophie.
Sophie the golden doodle.
Oh! Oh my god.
Change this world. Hands up.
Gratitude for days and days and days. So thank you guys. Have an amazing night. If you have any questions, please feel free to reach out. We'll talk soon.
You're gonna get an email with your case study, the one avatar that we're providing to you. You're also gonna get an email with the details on how to proceed with your guinea pig clients, when your 90-day assignment is going to be due, and how you're going to submit it with us. Please feel free to ask questions. I would encourage those of you that are serious about having a business, talk to Lori, do the mentorship. It's priceless, I promise. And when the Coaches Resource Membership site comes out, I hope I see so many of you guys in there, and I just can't wait to take you guys to the next level. But really, that's genuinely why we're all up here. So on behalf of all of them, I genuinely want to thank you. So you guys have an amazing night. Have an amazing weekend. Okay. Oh, we got fucking
nothing. I love it.
Oh. She's going to get so much more curly.
Oh, I love it. I hope so.
That face
is adorable.
Oh. Need to get her days and nights.
Yeah, we need to get her on a better sleep.
Because they're not, obviously.
Especially the one you're like, yeah, no. Especially this week.
Ready to go, Teddy?
Alrighty.
Alright, let's do it. Alright, guys, what's up? Monday morning, October 2nd. I look like a mess. It's been a long 4 days. Last Thursday, I flew to Seattle. Friday morning, I spoke at Luca Hostover's Vigor Fitness Summit. It was epic. I mean, just to be asked to speak there was amazing, but the quality of speakers that he had was nothing short of epic. I mean, I vividly remember standing on stage, looking over, seeing Martin Rooney. For those of you guys that know who Martin is in the strength conditioning world, I've been a fan of his for a long time. I vividly remember sitting in a cubicle, reading his stuff one day, just wanted to be like him, let alone meeting him and sitting, you know, standing and speaking on the same stage. And shout out to him real quick. He was a super humble dude, came up to me after the talk, really congratulated me and let me know how much he got out of it. And that was super cool. So to see it all come full circle like that was pretty cool. But gave my speech there. I was off stage at 11:50. I was in an Uber at 11:53. Literally on my way to the airport, get on a flight to get back, and we just hosted our second level one certification this weekend. And so here we are, Monday morning, October 2nd, and it should be theoretically 5 days from the end of shredding season. But you guys haven't seen an update in a while, and this video is meant to give you guys an update as to kind of why we disappeared, what happened with me, and I'm gonna say shredding season for me is over, and we'll talk about why. So I've been saying this would be the most vulnerable video, and I think it's really, I think every kind of fitness professional wants to always paint themselves in a positive light, and they always wanna act invincible, and I'm gonna tell you it's not the case for any of us, and I'm gonna break down to you exactly what happened. And so right after Chicago, we came back. Chicago really took it out of me. I put a lot of emotion going into that event. You know, I know that the level one certification that we have truly can change the world. I know that it can change a lot of lives. I know it can position a lot of people to pay it forward and to truly create impact in this world. And that's why we built it. Like, that was the genesis. You know, my team right now, we're 11, 12 people, but we're only 11, 12 people. And while we're all phenomenal at what we do, there's a very small number of people that we can touch relative to the whole world. And so my goal is to create impact, and I want to touch as many people in this world as possible. And I know that the people that walk away as level one coaches will go out and they'll make change, and they'll impact more people who will then impact more people. And you know, 40 years from now, like, the world will be in a much better place. And to think that we were at all a catalyst is epic, right? So with that in mind, I put a lot of pressure on myself going into that weekend. But let's think about all the external stressors that I already had. I was living in a calorie deficit. I had decided that there was going to be a performance component, so I was training super intensely. I was doing linear progressions in my, you know, power lifts, squatting, deadlifting, bench pressing, you know, trying to do some Oli lifts, trying to make sure that I get enough movement in, trying to do enough CrossFit work. Oh, and by the way, I was traveling all over the world to seminars. And so really my stress profile completely got out of hand. You know, I remember we finished up in Chicago, it was Sunday night, went to dinner with the team. I literally looked at them, put my credit card on the table, said, "You guys pay for dinner," and made me back in the room. Like, I was exhausted, and I came back and it only got worse. I didn't train for 4 to 5 days, and I didn't hit any sort of macros for 4 to 5 days. And the reality is I had a hard time recovering from it. And I had to take a long look in the mirror and be like, why am I really doing this? And you know, for those of you guys that have seen the previous shredding season videos, you know that the intro talked about becoming your best self. Transformation challenge is not like any other. It's not about crash diets. It's not about doing it the wrong way. It's about doing it the right way. It's about laying the foundation for the best you for the rest of your life. And I had to look at myself and say, is me chasing some sort of cosmetics? Is me chasing performance? Is that really becoming my best self? And the truth was, it was not. And you know, my best self, the reason I was put on this earth, I firmly believe, is to help other individuals, to educate and to pay it forward. And for me, cosmetics are secondary to all of that. So where I really get value out of my life is by being the best husband I can be, by being the best father I can be, by being the best friend, business owner, and boss that I can possibly be in every endeavor. So when I looked myself in the mirror that morning and I said, am I really gonna commit to continuing pushing myself to a worse and worse position? The answer had to be unequivocally no. So what did I do? How do we fix really what was becoming adrenal fatigue? I took a step back and I stopped training. Guys, I didn't train for 3 weeks. I also ate virtually everything in sight. You know, my solution was I didn't need the stress of doing some counting at the moment, because I knew it would make me neurotic and I knew it would make me a little bit afraid of food. Not to say that I didn't need to track. I did track what I was taking in to make sure that I was getting enough food, but I didn't have limits on what I could have, right? With that being said, it was probably the hardest 3 weeks of my life, because what comes with that? When you don't train and when you eat in a surplus, you obviously gain a little bit of body fat. Guys, I'm 13 plus years removed from my eating disorder and it still fucks with your head. So accumulating body fat in such a short amount of time is a very, very difficult process to go through. I had to go through it. I have an awesome person on my team, Amanda, that several of you guys know, that looks out for my macros, that I could send those vulnerable text messages to. Hey, it's hard to see myself adding body fat. Hey, it's hard to actually get this food in, right? It's not easy. And having that accountability for me was essential. Right, so fast forward 3 plus weeks, then it was time to actually put some training back in. I can tell you right now, my training protocol looks like at most 2 CrossFit sessions per week. They are classes because I just need something moderate intensity. I don't need something built out for me that's going to really overstress me. I know that if, you know, it's a 30 minute AMRAP and I get to 20 minutes and I feel like, man, I really want to quit. I know that's my adrenals really flaring up and I pull the plug right then and there. I'm not ashamed, right? Like, it's not a badge of honor for me to suffer through another 10 minutes. Like, I truly had to find what my limits were and begin complying to them. So even though so many of you guys know me as like, I'll hustle, 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 like, it has to become a controlled hustle. Because when you get to a point where you're not becoming your best self, it's really not worth it anymore. So why even make this video? The reason I'm making this video is there's so many of you guys out there that are chasing cosmetic pursuits and feeling like shit. I no longer wanted to feel like shit. Feeling like shit and looking good did nothing. It didn't help my family, it didn't help my business, and subsequently it didn't help you. And so if I was gonna go in and I was gonna tell you guys, hey, just kill yourself, I might as well be telling you, go out and get some templated diet that's gonna put you on 1200 calories. Because it's the same thing. You just starve, you end up feeling like shit, you create metabolic adaptation, and you create this vicious cycle of having a really poor relationship with food. So for me, it was about finding health, finding balance, finding success, and I truly believe 5 days away from the end of shredding season, that in all reality, I accomplished my goal. Sitting here right now, I am my best self. I didn't sleep at all last night because we got a new puppy, but I have plenty of energy to go work out right now. I know exactly what I can do in the training session. I know exactly what I can't do. We just crushed another level one. I didn't go to bed last night nearly as fatigued because I controlled the stressors in my life leading into it, including having to fly across the country in 24 hours. So guys, when I said this whole journey was about creating your best self, I meant it. And sometimes that means taking a step back and going in a direction that you never even thought was your best self. But I'll have Teddy insert my picture here that I took in the hotel room in Seattle. This is my physique right now, literally 4 days ago. So you can see, yes, I have still found a way, in my opinion, to make my physique better. I think it's very balanced, but I feel good, I'm performing well, I'm a great husband, father, boss, and our business is thriving. So guys, shredding season, 5 days left. Did you achieve your best self? Not your best physical self, not your best biofeedback self, but your best self overall. Did everything move forward? When you write your essay to finish this, I wanna know, where did your life change? How did your life change? What awareness did you create? Because for me, it was fucking eye-opening. And I can't wait to do this again next year. Maybe I didn't get super shredded with veins in my abs like Travis, right? But at the end of the day, I did become my best self. It was an eye-opening experience. I learned, and every time we learn, we move forward. So every single one of you guys that watch the videos that are taken down now, and yes, we recognize they're taken down, thank you. For those of you guys that have reached out and asked what happened, thank you. Hopefully this update explains it all. I genuinely appreciate each and every one of you. I hope you all learned a lot from your own individual journeys. And I'm super excited for the next phase because the vlogs aren't gonna stop. You know, Teddy and I are having a conversation. He's coming in even more full-time with our company. We're gonna be creating more and more content. We've got some very exciting news as to what's happening with IN3. So there you go. That's the new name of the company. I'll leave you guys there. You'll get another video explaining why we chose that name. But IN3 is on the takeover. Shredding season was a massive success. And I look forward to seeing you all in Vegas.
Boom.
Done. 'Cause tonight.